Hi, and welcome to Mr. Wilson Teaches, webisode Linoleum Printmaking. During this video, you're going to see all the steps that you need to create your very own print, and you're going to see them broken down in step, and also some close-ups of how to do it. The first thing you need is your supplies, and your supplies are as follows. Your brayer, which is just another word for a rubber roller, a sheet of plastic, and this is what you're going to be spreading your ink on, your ink, and it is possible to use more than one color if you choose to do so. You're going to need the actual linoleum that you're going to be carving into, and the one I'll be using today is an easy cut one, so it's very, very easy to gouge out. You're going to need a gouge, and your gouge should have multiple blade sizes, so if you were to open it up and look inside, there should be quite a few that vary from thin to thick. You're going to need a bench hook, and bench hook is called that because it's a hook that goes onto your workbench. You're going to need tracing paper as well as an image. It is possible to draw onto your linoleum, but for today I'm going to show you how to transfer an image so you're able to print something out and replicate it exactly. And you're also going to need a number 2 pencil and a Sharpie. So get all your supplies ready, as well as your paper that you're going to be inking onto, and then we'll go through the steps one by one.
Step 1 of the process is capturing your image, and we're going to do a transfer today. So that means taking the image that you've chosen, and for this assignment we have chosen to do animals. And remember, I want the animal to be a very realistic and a simplified drawing. And you can do this by typing in the computer, realistic, whatever your animal name, coloring sheet. And then you're guaranteed to get an easy to trace black line. And you're going to put your tracing paper down and go through each of the lines directly. If you have really thick lines, remember you do have to shade it all in with your pencil, just like it appears. And everything that's coming out in pencil here, or printer ink, those dark lines, those are going to be what is left on your linoleum, and that's what's going to print. You can also simplify or add to it. So let's say it's a pretty complex design and you want to edit some of it out. Or if it's a really easy design, you can also add stuff in. So as I trace, that's something I'm going to think about, if I want to add something in or take it out. And it's important that you take your time. Well, it's a very long process to create a print, and once you make it, the printing process is fairly quick. So it's really more time spent on the process than the final product. And I think I'm going to make mine into a poison dart frog, and that means that I'm going to have to add some spots onto it. So there's a dark area, remember I have to shade it in. And then I'm going to choose some areas. Add in these spots. And these I'm going to color in as well. And after you're done tracing, you get to transfer. And to transfer an image, you're going to take your linoleum, you're going to take your piece of tracing paper with your image on it, and this is the most important part, that you flip the image. If you don't flip the image, you're going to end up having to redraw it because it won't transfer properly. So you'll see the trace paper is already cut to size. This is a 6x6 print. I'm going to hold it in place, take the pencil, and I'm etching on the back of the tracing paper. And it really doesn't matter if you're using a pencil, it's all about the pressure. So I'm trying to do is apply enough pressure to the back of this so that it pushes the lead on the other side of this tracing paper onto the linoleum. Like I said, it really doesn't take a lot. And it's important that the tracing paper doesn't move while this is going on. If it does move, then you're going to end up with either a double transfer or something that doesn't match up, which does happen. And there's always the back linoleum if that does. And keep your finger there, check it, make sure you got all the parts, and then pull it up. And then you have your Sharpie next so that you can go ahead and outline everything. And the reason we're doing this in Sharpie is you'll notice the lines become a lot thicker with the ink, and they're going to be less likely to smear or disappear if they're done in Sharpie. And this is an important step because it's going to be very hard to get your blade to do such a small little area. So by thickening up these lines, you don't have to worry about that. Okay. And at this point too, you could also add stuff in if you didn't before. So if I wanted to add in any areas, take away, as you work with the Sharpie, you might find that these thick lines aren't going to work for certain parts of your design. So you can fix that, or you can keep going with it. This is going to get your whole print ready to be gouged next. And you're ready for the next step. Next step you're going to be working on is gouging your print. And to this, you're going to need your bench hook. And this is for safety reasons, and I'll explain that as we go on. You're going to need your linoleum that has already been traced, transferred, and outlined with a Sharpie. And you're going to need your gouge. The gouge is an important tool because it is what is going to clear all the linoleum. And if you unscrew the bottom, you'll see there's a couple different sizes of blades. And these are indicated by the number on the back. So I have a 1, 2, a 3, and a 5. And I'm going to start with my 3, and that's a medium-sized blade. So it's big enough to start with an outline, and then store all the rest of them back in where they go. And to load the gouge, in this area there'll be a small space. So I unscrew it, put the blade in, and then tighten it back up. And when you hold the gouge, a lot of people do different techniques. I find it easiest if you rest this in your palm, and then grip it and put your thumb right on the top so the blade is a V, and then you're going to scoop like an ice cream scooper. And the reason we have the bench hook here is if I were to slip, I'm going to end up hitting this bench hook instead of sliding off and possibly hitting someone else. And it's important to remember you're always carving away from your body and away from your hand. If you decide to curve as you go, it is possible to slip and accidentally cut back as well. I'm going to start by doing a couple practice ones and make sure I get the hang of it. And depending on how you flick your wrist, you can stop sharp and then scoop it out, or you can elongate and get a finer line. And then after I do a couple practice ones, I'm going to start by going around the frog. And what I'm trying to do is everything that's in black I'm going to save, and everything that's not in black has to go. So it takes quite a bit of time. And then watch as I rotate around the frog so that I'm always carving away from myself. And when you get to a corner like this, you have to flick up and then start in the groove for the next area and keep working your way around. And some of the curves can be a little difficult. Remember, you can always go in with a finer gouge. And if you slip, so notice I just went a little too far in, sometimes it is possible to fix up those areas. So I'm going to add back in a little Sharpie so that I have that thick line again, and then keep going. But there's only so far you can go with that. So if I do a real bad slip, so let's say I keep going and there was a line there, what would happen is I'd be pretty much out of luck. You can't really fill in areas once they're gone. So there's no way to get those areas back once you carve them out. And after I do the whole outline, I would then start on the inside with the same 1 of 3. And what I want is a raised edge. So that's where the ink would sit, whereas it wouldn't go in anywhere else. And I'm going to continue doing this, and I'll skip ahead and show you what it looks like when it's finished and it's ready to be inked. So here's my print of the frog. And you'll see I added a few more dots in there to give it a little more texture. And I ended up carving out everything except those dark lines. So this is a finished print. It's also possible to cut off some of the linoleum because I don't need that area, so it's just more work for me. I do save a lot of the inner areas though, and that's something for me to grab as I print. So you don't want it to go all the way to the edge. You're also gonna need your brayer. You're going to need ink, plastic, and your printing paper. The first step you're gonna do is take your ink and massage it, make sure that the oil hasn't, and the water, hasn't separated from the pigment. And then you're going to apply the ink onto the plastic. And a little bit of ink goes a long way. Remember, you can always add more, but you can't take it away. That's actually probably a little too much for this print, but we've got a big piece of plastic, so we'll work it out. Then you're gonna take your brayer, and you'll notice it's sitting on the table like this. You never leave your brayer on the table face up because it'll eventually flatten in that area, and also you'll ink your table. I'm gonna start by spreading the ink. And what we're looking for is a noise and a visual look. So it really has nothing to do with the way the ink is, because all inks are different. You really have to work for the certain sound and look. And ink's a lot tackier than paint. And I don't know if you can hear it here on the camera, but it is starting to give that tacky sound. And we're starting to lose the shine from the lights above us. And that's the type of texture we're going for. And when you get enough ink, you're going to roll it onto your print. And if you did this correctly, only the raised areas are going to pick up the ink. And a lot of times it takes a few sessions of gouging to get it correct. So you'll find areas that you thought you had, but it turns out they're too high and you have to go through and re-edit them again. I'm making sure I get all the areas. And notice I'm not following it all the way down. As I get to an area, I either pull my wrist up or go back. Once your linoleum is inked, you're then going to transfer it over to the paper. And to do this, you're going to take your print, hover it above the paper and let it fall, and you're going to lightly pat it. So you don't want to do this too hard or it can shift the whole print, or it can also squeeze a lot of the ink and get lines that are not as crisp as you'd like. I'm going through and patting it down. And if you inked it correctly, it should be pretty even. And then you're going to pull it up. And you can see it's very easy and quick to do these prints. And you can also change the colors as well. So this is a rainbow roll. You can see it goes from black to yellow to red. And depending on the effect you're going for, you can do multiple prints, map them. You can print on different colored paper. But there's tons of stuff you can do with this, and it goes very, very quick. You can also go through and edit stuff out still. So if I wanted to lose the dots on the frog, if I wanted to edit some of it, or you could, you know, the possibilities are really endless. So that's more or less the process, and then it's just more about experimenting with what types of inks and what kind of prints you want to make. So thank you for watching.